The Church Worldwide, the global recovery vessel reaching millions of vulnerable souls all over the entire world with the voice of Christianity, bringing the message of salvation, healing, teaching and deliverance to the brokenhearted, pointing all believers and non-believers to the resurrected Christ in his full immortal body, which is the Church of the Living God, the celestial city of the heavenly in Jerusalem. You are all welcome on board with us. Please join us now as Dr. Edmund brings a message of faith, hope, and deliverance.
Healing in your head.
Amen.
Healing in your lungs.
Amen.
Healing inside your rib.
Amen.
Healing in your waist.
Amen.
Healing in your tummy.
Amen.
Healing in your intestine.
Amen.
Healing in your blood.
Amen.
In your kidneys.
Amen.
Receive healing.
Amen.
Jesus will never allow her sheep to continue in your house. To make another person is from inside. The heart is inside. The spirit is inside. But God says, I will take away that old and wicked heart. He called it stony heart, impenitent. I will take it away. I give you a new heart and a new spirit. It is another heart that will make you another person. You have been moving about with the old heart. That heart is called the uncircumcised heart. But God says in Ezekiel chapter 36 verse 26 that a new heart and a new spirit will I put within you. All the whole defeat you have been suffering in your life, by the time you become another person, you become a winner. I'm telling you, become a conqueror. You become an overcomer. You go down. Down means battle. God told Moses, I have come down to deal with Pharaoh. And we all saw it in the Bible.
Praise the Lord. My name is Jeremiah Kono. I'm here to testify what God did during the day of the revival program. What happened is that for a couple of weeks, probably 3 to 4 weeks, I see my body that even to pray, to rise up in the night to pray, I find it difficult. So immediately I came in this wonderful revival. I see myself very light again. I give God the glory for his wonderful.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You could
Amen.
Not pray before now. That, you can rise up to pray.
That's fantastic.
And God bless you. That's wonderful.
That was a very
God bless you.
Quick one. Very quick.
Let's hear
one.
From you what Jesus
yes.
has done for you in the Kingdom
that
Recovery Church.
One.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord will praise
you. I asked you all eye pain last week. The pain was so severe that I cannot sleep in the night. I took some tablets to calm the eye down, to not have it. But due to prayer that I was coming to the anointing service and the revival, I suddenly see that pain in the eye have vanished. Yes.
Glory be to God. She was having pains in the eyes. She kept coming to fellowship. During the fellowship, the Lord healed her. God bless you.
God healed her in the fellowship.
God healed her in the fellowship.
This God, he notices everybody.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you, yeah.
God bless you, sister. God bless you. Tell us your name and what Jesus has done for you in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Brother, praise the Lord. I thank God for today anointing service. I came for open gate. The 3 days I came. This my waist like this. To this my left leg. If I sleep, in the night after I pray finish, this leg will hook me.
Wow.
But yesterday when we finish,
After prayer, will hook you.
It will hook me. I can say, use this leg for evangelism. It's for visitation. It's for all my boys, for God. Nobody can tear it.
After praying, it will
I'll
hook
you. I tell you, that is another arrow. I say, it's about to send that. But today, as I pray there now, as I say today is end. And I thank God, I say this talking now is another person.
Another person.
As I lay down there, this he hooked me. I said, yes, today you are finished.
He hooked you?
He hooked me now. When I get to the, I'm free.
Oh, wow.
I'm free now. I become another person. Hallelujah.
Hold on.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he hooked you not only now, he hooked you in the night as well. After you pray.
After I pray.
So go and sleep tonight.
Amen.
You understand me?
Yes, sir.
When he come to hook you, you hook it.
He can't come again, sir.
In Jesus' name.
No, Jesus'
God bless you. That's fantastic.
Hallelujah.
That was a very.
God bless you.
Please
tell us your name, what Jesus has done for you in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Let them praise the Lord. My name is Jugochi Chinedu. I'm from Oweyemi Kota. Yesterday, I get teeth pains almost 14 years now. So see, I know they use this side, and it's 14 good years.
14 years.
Good years, yes.
14 years.
14 years.
Toothache.
This side. So this tonight, the suffering since reached yesterday, open gate. I said, God, as I come here yesterday, the last one, say, God, if Baba use Baba, even that way, can you make this teeth, make him come out? I want make this teeth come out. As we there yesterday, our Baba can't touch us. Immediately I reach for them. Immediately to reach the gate, I see what to come out from my mouth. See him. See the teeth pain.
Hallelujah!
You know, there was somebody.
Yes.
There was somebody here in the choir had the same experience.
Exactly.
Who was that person? You are the one. You see now.
Exactly.
If you were doubting that of that day, what of this one? No, what of this?
Open your hands so that they can zoom.
No, think about this. What of this one? You see that?
14 years toothache taken away in the open gate revival.
If
14 years toothache.
I will stand up and shout, Jesus!
Hallelujah! This is an awesome miracle of God in the Kingdom Recovery Church. 14 years toothache taken away. 14 years toothache.
Listen. I want those of you on this line, please come. Go and see it. Go very closely. I don't think you saw it very well there.
The witness that it is a
go and see. Go. Very, I've never seen that type of teeth. Can that be truth? Now, wow. You see it? For you to confirm that there is somebody called Jesus Christ, and this Jesus Christ is available. A bales of cloth floated on the water, and that happened. We're telling you of there's a person doing it. That's what I just told you this evening. That's the message. He told God, and to be honest with you, the Almighty God who put it in my spirit is a witness. Someone with toothache. Then you don't have to live here unprecedentedly. That was not planned.
Exactly.
I began to touch. As she was touched, the devil became uncomfortable. Is it in your house this thing went out or here?
Forget
here.
Yes.
He came out for gate.
Yes.
And you came here for open gate. Woo! You see what I'm saying?
Gate.
You see what we're saying? Somebody shout miracle.
Miracle.
Shout power.
Power.
Shout power.
Power.
Shout power.
Power.
That is it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 14 years to take.
When we say come for anointing service, these are the things you hear. One of those ushers. Get this you. Go over there, madam.
She should be invited.
Yes, and they put it. You see, things have been destroyed. The devil might have sent a dangerous arrow and destroy that teeth like that. I've never seen a human teeth like that. Why wouldn't he be troubling you for 14 years?
14 years. Toothache.
Is that what she said?
Taking away at the gate.
That is what I'm telling you. You have confidence. When you carry the Bible, you know what you're carrying. But when you're carrying Bible with the defiled mind, the defined brain, defined heart, the devil will be laughing at you. Because you have every right to be free and you're in bondage. When Bible is in your house, apothecary is in your house. When Bible is in your house, I want to tell you that power is in your house. Yes. Clinic of heaven is in your house.
Yeah. Praise the Lord. Yesterday, I managed myself 5:30. I always be at church. I just manage myself to carry myself to church, and after arranging everything, clean everything, I go back house and I dress, come back to church, and I cannot even stand up to do the work of worship. I sit as I cannot do any work today. I sit down throughout yesterday till when we close. But now after I come to the workers meeting, and because I like to dance, when that dancing start, my mind just says, stand up and dance. That's the way that sickness and
sure.
everything.
Sure.
So, as I know to say, and my mind tell me, say, well, if I step this place, this is treatment, and I'm going to the hospital to take treatment. So I start dancing. After that dancing, you know, we go to up and dance.
Hallelujah! I say hallelujah!
Before I know, all the pain, everything just disappeared. See, now I'm strong and healed.
Hallelujah!
Don't forget, yesterday, did I not say that? This, because I perceived that God was.
Yes.
There was anointing on the choir. Did I not? Are you one of those who bought malt?
Special refreshment.
Let every chorister here drink one can of malt. Did I not tell you that there was something very special about yesterday's choir thing? That everybody should go and give a
refreshment to them.
You understand? And I don't know. But you see, all right, go there.
God bless you. Tell us what Jesus has done for you in the Kingdom Church.
Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. So that service, open gate. If I come here, if I begin every time, if I even do. I go market. Something go hold me. Like say, I no go get myself. And when I come up for house, I dey fine. I will go meet my children. Say, something they worry me. They say, now, what it happen? I say, something they worry me for this my chest. I no feel fine. And before that thing start, I go day weak. I no go get myself. So as I call for that prayer, for that open gate on Friday, so both this leg and they feel pain for yeah every time. So as pastor say, make the rub hand for where they pain us. And they rub hand for yeah.
Your own hand though.
They rub hand.
And that hand they with you for your house for a long time.
Yes.
Tete.
Uh-huh. So as I call for the prayer, and they rub hand for the chest, they rub for my leg.
How long this thing don't start for your body?
It don't start, it don't reach like 2 years and a half now. I dey go here. But if I reach market, I no go get myself. I say, wait till happen. I be man no come
you
market.
You go market today?
I go today.
Now. How today be?
Today I dey free.
Hallelujah.
That's the testimony.
Open gate.
Bless you. Go over there.
Wonderful.
Look at that.
God bless you, sir. Tell us what Jesus has done for in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Peter Ifa in Chukubani. I come to testify before the congregation of people what God has done for me for these 2 days. I usually go out for morning cry early in the morning. So since I started it again, I begin to have this attack from the chest to the back. The chest will be hurting me. So I said, whether you like it or not, I must go. Even though I was feeling the pain, I pray finish, I enter. And I went for the morning cry. So when I came back, within 10 minutes, I found that the sickness disappeared. I tried to feel it. How is this thing happening? I didn't receive it again till this evening. So I have to glorify the name of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Went for morning cry and God is healing. God bless you.
As short as
tell us what Jesus has done for in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord. My name is Friday Bubu from Oyemi Quarter. It was last week Friday, I was going to Ireland because I used to learn driving school at Ireland. So I took a bus going to Relay. So when I get to Koka, the vehicle breakdown. So I took another one going to Lagos. So when I took the bus, so when we got to Orile, a trailer was coming from the side. So we hit the vehicle that I was inside. So the vehicle now, one side now go now bend to one place. So and he hit it again. The next thing I can see, the motor now park well. Everybody was shouting, yeah, yeah. But only as I shout Jesus, the God of Pastor Edmond, so the motor now park well.
Wow, wonderful.
That means that my God is also a driver.
Yes, sir.
He can drive motor.
Yes,
he can brake motor. Yes, he can park motor.
Yes, exactly.
This God is wonderful.
Hallelujah. God bless you.
Go over there. God bless you
for that wonderful testimony. God bless you. Tell us what Jesus has done for in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is good.
All the time.
You know, last Monday, when we were here, the apostle said we should come out. When I came out, he was praying. So, reaching my own tongue, he said, "You are thinking too much. That is your own problem." I said, "God has heard my cry. Because my wife, she's heavy. So, on Wednesday, she delivered a baby boy." I said, "God, you have done it again." Hallelujah.
But what was he thinking?
Actually, I believe that thinking, that prayer have reached where it's supposed to reach. That was the smoke that apostle saw. Then he said,
"Smoke,
what you are thinking."
go by there. Glory be to God. Listen.
Wow.
Let somebody not be afraid.
Amen.
Of a tree. A very tall tree. That tree is so much feared in your place. That tree, very tall, but it's a spiritual tree. Some people believe in that tree, they worship that tree. But what happened two nights ago? So I have a message for you. In the name of Jesus, don't fear that tree. It has been cut down.
Yeah.
Is there any tree in your place that has a particular name? And that tree is where they worship. It has a priest in charge of it. Maybe you are the one I'm talking to. Are you here tonight? A tall tree. If you're here tonight, you are the one I'm talking to. If that person is not here, we're going to repeat this again. We're going to repeat it. Tall tree, it has been cut down. And that tree, the spirit of that tree has caused so much problems in the village, including in your family. Where is that gentleman?
Are you the one man of God is talking about?
Yes, sir.
You?
Yes, sir.
Where do you come from?
Benue.
Benue?
Yes, sir.
Have you got any news yet? And
Not at all. Just like this prophet just affect me because it has been long. When I was in primary 4, my mom told me concerning those tree. That is very mighty tree in my village. So the tree, there were three, but two. They have already cut two. Very heavy tree. This tree, just like the first one, they cut the first one. There is a dog fowl jump out of the tree. So with different kind of clothes inside the tree.
Clothes?
Yes, yes.
Dog?
Yes.
Inside the tree?
Yes, sir. So even though the man has cut the tree, that very day, the man died that very day. So the last one, the tree is there now, up to now. They try to cut the tree up to now. Nobody can try it. So the tree is there up to now.
Somebody stand up on your heels. Somebody point this brother. Tell him, my brother. Don't be afraid.
The Lord
has cut down that tree, which no man can cut. And this tree fell. I will not tell you where it fell. It fell upon something. Let's leave that one. It's very hard to explain. That is it. You are going to get the news.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is going to send the wind.
Amen.
Into your village. And the sort of wind that have not blown before shall blow in your village.
Amen.
And there'll be a news.
Amen.
That will make a history.
Amen.
In a village.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want all of you to cancel that in 1 second. Just pray and cancel it in Jesus' name. Cancel that tree. In Jesus' mighty name. Oof! As simple as that. Look at that. That tree has caused a lot of problems in the family, but I tell you, it is done in Jesus' name. You pray. Look at that. Let's see what I'm saying. That's it. You see, that I told is a spiritual tree. It was governing their family, governing many people, not only their family. You evil tree, Jesus is the vine, the tree of life, and this brother and all of us are his branches. I command you in Jesus' mighty name, go out of this person, because you are a tree and you have already been cut down.
Let's hear from you, sister, what Jesus has done for you in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Praise the Lord, brethren. Last week, Tuesday, there's a heavy fever that came on me. And I did test on Friday. They said the result of everything that was troubling me is typhoid, that is too much on me. That's what is causing that headache on my head. But I cannot give the devil the chance to lie down at home and begin to collect some treatment. Since that Tuesday, I'm always in the fellowship, in VG and in all the programs. And yesterday night, the Lord used our beloved man of God to wind it up at the laying of the hands through that prayer. And by the special grace of God, I wake up this morning, that headache was gone permanently. And this is the test of the result and the money for the treatment. And I tell God that the Lord has taken it away. I don't need any treatment. I'm going to lay the money on our apostle feet. That the Lord should perfect everything and never again in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank God, that's an awesome miracle again.
She has to open
the
that.
The Lord has healed her.
Open, what is that? What's your result? Open it. So the heaven and earth will see it. You see, as we have been, there are some watching at you there. He has seen this television. That is how people are seeing it anywhere in the world. Now, okay. Look at that. Mm-hmm. It didn't show because it was manuscript. Okay. Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I want to thank you because you have finished the enemy. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Finally, you never again, visit that very body. The spirit that come to steal money. Elohim. Somebody shout power. Shout power. Shout power. I don't know what people need. What do you need? Is it power? There are a lot of powers out there. Someone shout Jesus.
Jesus!
Someone shout Jesus is the power.
Jesus is the power.
That is it. Jesus Christ of Nazareth makes you free. Hallelujah. He says she made a vow to lay the money on apostles' feet. Is my feet bank? Is it an account office? So my feet is now accountant. Now, wow, all right. Can you please have this so that you can please pick it up so you can give it to the yeah. Well. Okay.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. So my testimony goes like this. In each my daughter is delivered. That deliver, he go to clinic. Then say the doctor say you won't deliver. Say make them go carry load come. So after say make you go carry load come. This is deliver. Make a yes say you don't boy. You know boy. And the doctor say the head, the picking head don't reach down. My daughter begin to call all the friends. They call all the members. Say ah. Then give them admission the hospital, give them admission. And they not say yes, he carry belly. So as he that deliver almost 3 days, he sit there for hospital. People pray. I say, ah, this one don't pass everybody. Make a call daddy. Now Jesus can't take over. Deliver that child. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus,
Lord, we praise thee.
Glory be to God. She called man of God, difficulty in delivery. The Lord took over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you. Tell us what Jesus has done for you in the Kingdom Recovery Church.
Praise the Lord. It happened last week, Monday. I woke up in the morning. I had muscle pain on my neck, and it was God that helped me resolve. And throughout that week, I had pains at the right side of my ribs. I came on Friday, being the first day of revival, open gate. After the prayer of the man of God, he said you should lay hands on any part of our body where we had pains.
So you are going to pray. All the whole problem from the chest to the stomach. If you understand what you are doing, what you are talking about to God, you will see it now. You see it now flushing away. You will be a witness. Are you ready? Open your hands. Precious God Almighty, I pray over these people's palms. Several times many have confirmed that you have so much blessed their palms, and their palms have been blessed. They now use it in a blessed way. When they touch, the blessings of Abraham will flow. Let it be that as they touch their body, Jesus of Nazareth will penetrate.
Amen.
And break through.
Amen.
Because they are about to enter. The reason is that the gate of heaven is open.
Amen.
So that's your portion.
Amen.
Are you ready?
Yes,
see, you see miracle now. Someone shout miracle.
Yes,
that is children's bread. Now, if you have that problem from your neck to your stomach, you know, your chest, your breast, anything in the front, from neck to the lower abdomen of your stomach, of your belly, just pray and lay that hands there and command it to go with violence, and they will leave you alone. Come on now, prayer in Jesus' name, prayer. Even if it is HIV, the Lord will burn it with fire, burn it to ashes. I rebuke blockade hindrances. How receive your marriage, no matter how difficult. I change everything by the power in the word, by the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. This is your portion.
And after I laid my hands, I got my miracle. I got my healing that day
on the first day of open gate.
Where did she got healing that first day? What happened the second day and the third day? She remained healed?
Yes, sir.
And you are still healed
now? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Still healed?
Yes, sir.
In the anointing service.
Wow.
Miracle
remain. Hallelujah.
Please, let's rise up. You can't defy giving God his glory. God is time before time. So the Lord will bless your time.
Amen.
You're going to stretch forth your hand and pray for these beloved ones. All of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I think they are odd number here. 13? Am I correct? 6, 8. That's I'm right. That's 13 number. So you are going, you see this number 13. Can I ask, what can divide number 13? Tell me. What, which figure can divide it? Can any figure divide 13? That is how nothing shall divide this most miracle. Pray in Jesus' mighty name. Pray in Jesus' mighty name. Pray in Jesus' mighty name.
Oh, thou power of God, Father Lord in heaven, your miracle shall not be divided, the miracle remain permanent. Let it be that what you have done in your life, oh God, the devil cannot take it away. It shall remain permanent in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, thou spirit of the Most High God. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus, 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 glorify yourself. And let the devil be put to shame.
In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Jesus Christ makes you free. Jesus Christ makes you free. When I touch you, go back to your seat. You see, this people saying that they went to the hospital, they went there, they spend that money and all that. Oh my God. You see, watch it. The sign for you, gentlemen, I heard the one from Benue. Yeah, the proof is that the Almighty God will take away that hardship, that difficulty you used to have.
Amen.
So when you see it happen, you know that the Lord has taken away power. Amen. By power.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, Jesus Christ makes you free. Jesus Christ makes you free. In the mighty name of Jesus, Jesus Christ makes you free. Hallelujah. Your miracles remain. Amen. Nothing can divide it. In Jesus' mighty name. Wow. Wow. I want to thank God Almighty. Assuming we have not found Bible by now, I just want to thank God. We can't thank God enough. All these things you are seeing that are happening is from the Bible. This book. Read it. Don't put it under your pillow, so that it will protect you from witchcraft. Rise up now. Precious God Almighty, I want to thank you for what you've done.
Thank you for watching today's episode of A Moment of Recovery.
Fully believe that you have been blessed by the words from the anointed servant of God, Apostle Edmund.
Having any questions, comments, prayer requests, and testimonies you want to share with us?
You can do that by sending them through the phone numbers and emails displayed on the screen.
For we are ready to hear from you.
We hope to see you in another exciting moment of recovery.
God bless you.